Joining me in the trend zone this week, you've seen her everywhere in New Orleans, mostly from the huge success of her hit single, Hit Me With That Hammer. She's a 3-time NOLA Hip Hop Award recipient for Best Bounce Artist, Hottest Bounce Song, and the Soulja Slim Award. She's also a NOLA Choice Award recipient for Best Artist. You've also seen her featured in Expo Magazine. You may have seen her in a city near you doing motivational speaking engagements. She's the founder of the Making Major Moves movement, and she's here to promote her new EP entitled The Unchurched Experience. It features her new hit single, Hang On. I'm so excited to welcome her as my guest. Please welcome Miss Keedy Black. So, hey, honey.
Hi.
It's so crazy because let me tell you how I got you here. I was driving in my car one morning, right? And so the hook from Hammer just popped in my head. And I was like, man, like, you know, I was going crazy. I was like, I wonder what happened to my girl. Because at the time when it had first dropped, I was working somewhere across the river. And I used to listen to the Power Posse in the morning, Big A, DJ Chicken. And they used to play the song every morning. And I used to be all on the steering wheel, like, just dancing, you know, getting my life. So fast forward a few days later, I log on to Instagram. P-Town Mo posted a video of you. And you were talking about one of my favorite subjects in the world, women empowerment. And I was like, oh my God, I have to have her on my show. So I'm glad I found you and I'm glad you agreed. And I'm glad, like, now we're here. All right.
Yes, I'm excited too.
And to my surprise, you did like a whole 360. You doing gospel bounce now.
Well, actually, it's really not a 360.
What do you
call
it?
When I did Hammer, I did, you know, like a gospel side of Hammer as well.
Really?
Yes, and I was performing it when I came out with Hammer, but people just wasn't paying attention to that because they were so busy watching Hammer, Rock My World, and other sides of me. So, well, it was overcrowding that.
Why the big change, though?
My heart just, and it just was like I was getting tired. I just started getting weary. I was like, you know what? I just can't just do this or whatever. And I wound up getting pregnant with my dad's baby, and I rolled all the way through my whole pregnancy. No one ever knew that I was pregnant until like 8 months, and they thought I was 3 months.
Why you hit it?
I just was rolling, working, just. So they're like, wow, this happened so fast. And you know, when I had him, everything just went to happening so fast. And once I had him, I just was like already getting deeper in my word. And I was like, God, show me, direct me, and show me what to do. Mm-hmm. And it just started wearing on me. Like, I can't no longer just, you know, do this. I have to show the world who I am and just be me.
I think you really did that because I remember when Magnolia Shorty had just got killed. I guess that was my first time hearing of you. It's just like you kind of feel that void. Listening to Hammer, it's like when that beat dropped and it came in like, you're the only one I... It's like, it's that chill factor. It's like she was really reliving through you. Did you know her growing
right.
up?
Yes, we like sisters. We're cousins.
Really?
We grew up like sisters. So, you know, best friends.
What kind of stuff y'all used to do together?
We did just about everything together. You know, we did each other hair. We shared secrets. We fought together, you know, we marched in parades.
Fought other people together.
Yes, not against each other. We never fought against each other. We actually never even much had a fuss, you know, or whatever. So we always had an understanding. So I was her safe haven and she was mine. We used to be in a bum bags at a young age, just beating on a bum bags when we punished or something. Or if it's a rainy day and we can't go outside. And we'll rap about anything, like a roach. Or something. Like, I remember we made up a rap about a roach. And we used to do a lot of rapping. And I can remember when we was real young, we formed a choir. So we got together. Her father is into music. Well, he passed right after her. So he was into music. Mm-hmm. And his mom had a church. So we was forming a choir, and we got like two other girls out the project. We began to put our own tour together, and we'll go to different church, and we'll ask, hey, can we come and perform? And they'll be like, yes. So we went to Fifth African Baptist. We performed there. We used to go and practice with their choir. That's actually where she had her funeral. Her funeral was held at that church. And we had he was a security guard at our middle school, and we never knew that he was a pastor. We never knew that he was a pastor, Pastor Malone. And he wound up, he said, I'm a pastor. And I said, you ain't no pastor. So we said, well, let us come to your church. And let us come to your church and rap and sing or whatever. And my grandmother wound up going to that, was going to that church at the time. So we went to the church and we got up to go perform and stuff like that. So we'll rap and sing. And soon she see a boy she like or something, then she'll go sit down and she'll act all shy, and then she wouldn't want to do it because she'll be embarrassed that she's singing, you know, for the Lord and stuff like that. And I was always bold about this. So I got up there and I did it by myself.
Do you remember y'all last conversation together?
Yes. I remember that like yesterday.
What was it like?
She was like, come on, Key, you have to come on. We're going out, you know. Because it's like every time, that whole weekend when she was calling me to come out, I was like, I'm coming. And, you know, I was busy with my kids and stuff like that. And I had other things going on. I was working. You know, she didn't have kids at all. So she just was free, lancing, just enjoying life. And I can remember that Sunday, I told her, I'm coming. And I never came. Mm. And the next morning, you know, she passed. She was murdered, at least. She was murdered.
Where were you when you got the news?
I had a nursery. So I actually was at my nursery. And I got the call, and somebody said, I don't know what's going on with Shorty, but something is going on at her apartment. So I kept calling her, and it would ring and go straight to voicemail, and I just went there. And
oh, so sorry for your loss. Rest in peace, Magnolia Shorty. She was definitely a
queen.
Legend.
Legend.
Definitely.
Idol.
The new chick that's out now, Reedy. For so long, I thought people were getting y'all names confused. I really thought she was you. Like the song that she have out now. You know, she kind of got the club scene on lock right now. You can't go in there without hearing any of her songs. So looking at her and her career, where do you think the future of female rap bounce is headed?
Well, actually, I really don't know, because it just keep amazing me how it keep flipping over and it just keep turning to and going to different levels and different styles or whatever. But Reedy was my dancer.
Oh.
She's actually my little cousin.
Oh, okay.
We cousins or whatever. And it's crazy how my connection with Shorty and my connection with her, but I'm not as closest with her as I was with Shorty or whatever. So I'm excited for her, you know. I mentor, talk to her, mold her as much as I can, you know, and I try to get her to change different things and whatever, but she's real young and she's doing her thing right now. So, you know, whenever she calls me and need advice, I'm here. I'm open, you know. I'm
Absolutely.
Excited about what she have going on, but you know. And it's crazy because she moved in at a perfect time.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, like I'm beginning to evolve. And I'm moving out the space, and she came in the space. So it was like perfect timing. She actually came with me to speak at a speaking engagement I had.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually was able to speak about that and see how God is moving me in another arena, and how she was able to come in and feel in that spot. Just as well as when Shorty left, I was able to come in and feel in that spot. And now it's Reedy who's here feeling in that spot. And there's other young up-and-coming bounce artists that I see that, you know, has good work and that's working hard and that's trying to get up there or whatever. So I'm excited about, you know, it's a lot of females that's working now. It's not just, you know, a gay rapping things or whatever. So, but, you know, not knocking any gay artists or anything. I love them. But now I'm seeing a lot of females that's embracing it, a lot of females that's stepping out and being bold about it and, you know, but I just wish that their lyrics would change a little, because it's like we have a lot of Magnolia Shorties, you know, or whatever. That never was my rapping style. That was her style, you know, just living through me or whatever. So, like I say, it's just a lot of, I just hear a lot of Magnolia Shorties, you know, a lot of Magnolia Shorties coming behind Key Black or whatever, and I need to hear something different.
You mean like?
The lyrics.
The lyrics. Or the content?
Meaning,
you want it to be more positive, but, or what?
Well, they're just rapping about the same thing. You know, it's all the same thing.
What you think about Frida's song that she got out right now?
I heard it once, but I never really sit down to get into it or whatever. So I really don't have a comment on it right now, because I need to get into it.
Okay. Because I think the theme in rap music this year is unity, with all the collaborations going on, you know, and, you know, the name, the major ones, like Remy and Kim, Nicki and Cardi. Do you think that women are starting to get more respect in this game? nowadays.
Yes.
And because you know what I hate? Like when men say disrespectful things about women, or even they post it on social media. And the first thing you do when you click in the comments is other women, like with the crying face emojis, the LOLs, the liking of it. And it's like, sis, like back your sister up. At least be on her side, because at one point that can be you too.
Oh, I won't talk about this so much. Like I can really sit here all day and talk about this during the whole show.
It's crazy, right?
My thing is this, like, I'm not never gonna try to tear another woman down. Mm-hmm. Some women, they feed off that. Tearing another woman up, down, it builds them up. Mm-hmm. Like, that don't build me up. So I just never understood it. Like, you'll go shade this woman because she have something you want. You'll shade this woman because you feel like you want to take the light that she's in. Mm-hmm. You want to dim her light to make yours shine. And I don't think that's cute at all. I see a lot of women do it, and I really want to talk about it. Like, you know, I'm about to start having little segments to where I talk about different things that need to be spoken on. See you dating a certain guy, and they want to date this guy, so they want to shade you, or they want to knock you in this area here or there, or they see you driving a certain type of car that they want. Instead, they're trying to get with you and see, well, hey, how are you doing this? Can you show me? Can you teach me? No, you want to shade me. So at the end of the day, they have to stop, ladies. Stop being shady now. All that shady stuff, it don't even much amount up to nothing. It don't make no sense at all, you know?
Alright, so here's what's trending. My girl Khloe Kardashian just got a heart torn out of her chest. Videos recently surfaced of, I don't know if that's her fiance or whatnot, of him interacting with other women in a club and allegedly taking them into a hotel room. And my thing is, why can't these men be faithful? At least up until the point to where they give birth. I mean, we heard stories about Kevin Hart and his scandal. Are we that difficult to deal with during pregnancy? Take your time on that one. I just want to hear your perspective. What is going on?
I don't know. I don't know what their problem is. I don't know.
And Cardi B is pregnant. Are you excited for her pregnancy?
I'm happy for everything for Cardi B.
I'm so glad she's getting overwhelming support. It seems like everybody is on her side. Because to me, like, and given a recent video of him that just came out, of him with another woman, I think it's kind of like a positive reinforcement to force him to kind of do the right thing. So hopefully, like, all the people that's against them saying they don't approve of it, she should do better, hopefully. And I would rather, like, him prove them wrong than to for them to be proven right. So
I'm happy for Cardi. I just hope that she's making a wise decision, you know.
Right.
And only she can make decisions for Cardi. You know, no matter how people bashing or what people say, or, you know, even if they're rooting her on, like, she have to make decisions for herself. Life is all about decisions, and I'm just praying and hoping that she's making the right decision.
Yeah, because this industry is so grimy.
Yes, it is.
Especially in Hollywood. Yes.
All the time.
Oh, my God. Eve, did you hear the story about her when she was, like, somebody drug tied at an industry party? And get this, Janet Jackson actually came to her rescue.
Wow.
And had to, I guess, take care of her until the drugs wore off or whatever. Have you ever been in a situation to where you thought you were in good company, but then it turned out to be something working against you or something?
Well, actually, I don't drink. I'm not a smoker. I never have been a drinker or a smoker. But I done had people try to invite me to pills or to smoke or whatever. And I just let people know, if you don't see me openly and willingly and looking for this, don't invite it to me. So if anybody try to invite or, you know, give me something like that, I just automatically, it's just a cutoff.
Right.
Gotta cut them off.
All right. So Baby and Wayne, I want to talk about them. It looks like... It looks like they reunited, though. It looked like things are on and up and up, and it looks like the Carter Five may be about to be released. What are your thoughts on this situation?
I have nothing to say. I just hope Wayne is making a right decision, you know, or whatever. So I just hope he's making a wise decision, and I hope, you know, Baby do better by him.
Yeah, because New Orleans need more wins. Yes. I'm going to say that. Oh, and speaking of wins, shout out to Tokyo Vanity.
All right. Damn so,
She just landed on Roll All Up Hip Hop Atlanta. You've been watching the show?
I saw it. I'm not into that kind of stuff. I'm kind of weird to myself because when I look at other women and I see the stuff that they're into, and I've never been into stuff. I'm not a gambler. I don't play cards. Like a lot of women play cards. You know, I never did that. Like I have a reason why I don't do that. I like to see my money, so I'm not a gambler. I like to see.
Oh yeah.
You know, when I spend my money, I want to know where I spend it. I want to be able to see. Okay, this is what I work hard for, or whatever. But Love & Hip Hop is just a lot of mess. So I'm not into that. You know, mm-hmm. like I'll just tune in and watch, you know, when my fiance, when he watch it or whatever, and now I'm in a room. So I watch it, but I really sit there and I watch to see, you know, what was going on with Tokyo and, you know, was, you know,
how I think she the whole city is behind it. That's probably why
it's awesome.
They all watching it right now. Because everybody been saying the same thing pretty much. They stop watching it and they watch it.
I watch it just because of her or whatever, and, you know.
Yeah, I think that's beautiful. One step closer to a Love & Hip Hop New Orleans franchise. What you think?
Well, Mona came down here a couple of years ago to do a New Orleans Love & Hip Hop. And I actually got a contract for it.
Oh, wow.
And it just didn't work out. Like, a lot of people that she wanted to put on, they didn't want, you know, like, big artists from New Orleans. They didn't want to participate or whatever happened with that situation. And then she moved to L.A. She went to, you know, Love & Hip Hop LA or whatever. So I don't know if she may revisit here and come back, but I did an interview. It was awesome.
Who do you think will make a good New Orleans cast from here?
We have so many characters.
Your top picks, name them.
We have P-Town Mo.
Of course.
Bounce artists or
anybody doing anything that you think will be good in front of the camera?
I think P-Town Mo, he'll be real funny and, you know, it'll be like a journey following him with the camera. I say Ruju and his wife.
The family.
Yes, the family thing. And if you want like characters, real characters, Tinwa Book.
My boy.
And Truly, they'll be good for it. And Big Freedia have his own show. So, but you know, he's absolutely, you know.
You think he'd do it?
Love & Hip Hop?
Yeah. You think that's
I don't think he'll be able to do it with the contract that he has with, you know, the people that he have the other show with.
Yeah, because you know he's mainstream now, but if he wasn't in.
Right, if he wasn't in that situation, then I think it'll be something that he'll do. Sissy Nobe, I'll throw Nobe in there. Because Nobella is very, yes. I really believe that Nobe will be good for something like that. We all know Super. Mm-hmm. Super will be good for that. She really have this thing about her just, you know, she good with speaking and, you know, getting in front of the camera.
And she's funny too, I agree.
Jess.
Mm-hmm.
Jess is
the mogul.
Yeah. So she's already making these moves with all these different big artists and stuff like that.
I think it's coming. But I think that's a clear sign of maybe like at the end of the season they'll say, oh, she moving back to New Orleans and then boom, I Love & Hip Hop New Orleans pop up.
Never know.
Never know.
You never know.
All right.
I hope they cut me a check.
Heller. Get on them. All right, so I want to play a game with you, and I don't want to infringe on your Christian values, so it's very similar to Marry, Kill, Smash. You ever played that game before? It's like when you hear three people's names, you put them in whatever category you want. So either you'll marry them, you'll kill them off, or you'll smash them. But in this case, we're going to be playing something
God,
called...
God, ain't got nothing to do with me when I was Christian and all that.
Is this? Oh, okay.
I am streets. I love the Lord, but I am street, baby.
All right, so you want to keep the original
name?
You want me to? Yes.
You believe in God?
Yes.
So what's the difference?
Because I'm just like that with people. I never want to make you feel uncomfortable. Right. I always take whatever you feel into consideration. Right. But if you want it that way, you know, that's how we'll do it.
So what I'm going to do, I'm going to smash?
Yeah, it's marry, kill, smash.
Okay. So either you'll marry. What you mean when you say smash?
You know what I mean when I say smash.
What you mean when you say
smash? Hit it and quit it. That's what I'm talking about. You already know.
All right, come on.
All right, So first we have from the movie Black Panther, the character T'Challa, Killmonger, or M'Baku. Have you seen?
Yes, but I don't remember their names.
Yeah, all right. So
the king.
All right, so Michael B.
Jordan.
Which
one is the king?
They all are kings.
No, the head king, the one who came in after his father passed.
T'Challa. That's the one you're going to marry?
Okay.
And the Killmonger was Michael B. Jordan's character. So he was from the Rival Nation.
So we talking about their characters from the movie?
Yeah, we talking about their characters. What? But all them, it don't matter. They're all the same. But I feel like people would know who they are more if I mention the characters they play.
Okay, so Michael B. He all right, but I don't like the character he played in the movie.
Yeah, he was so mean to people.
I smash him. Not smash him like that, but kill him. Smash him.
Oh, okay. All right. And so, all right, we know what
else. Because in my world, smashing mean killing. Smashing could be, like you said, or whatever, but kill him. He out of here.
Gotcha. All right, so from the TV show Empire, Andre Lyon, Jamal Lyon, or Hakeem Lyon?
Kill all of them.
Why? Not a one? Not a one? Okay. So, from the TV show Power, Kanan, Ghost, Tommy. I'm gonna see.
Tom is the white guy.
Yeah.
Pow.
That's
kill.
A kill?
Yes,
kill Tom? Okay. Who would you smash?
Which one is your girl husband? Which one? What is name to?
Ghost. The lead character?
Ghost. That's what is name daddy?
James St. Patrick. Oh.
You know what I'm talking about, the girl? What her name is?
Tasha, yeah.
What's her husband name?
Ghost.
Smash.
Of course. I knew you was gonna say that. All right. So you would kill 50? No, you would marry 50. Yeah, because you would kill Tommy. So you marry 50.
Wait, hold up. So I'll marry, what is his name?
That means you'll marry Kanan.
Yes, I'll marry Kanan and smash. No, 50 gonna get smashed. She ain't get married. He ain't get married from that scene. He ain't get married. Your boy get married. What his name?
Ghost.
Marry Ghost, smash 50, and kill Tommy.
Okay. All right. So the last one from your White House. Bill Clinton, Barack Obama, Donald Trump.
Girl, you already know I'm marrying and smashing Obama. And killing everything else. I'm going to smash him first, then marry him. Yay. All
right.
A marriage right, first information. Okay.
You hilarious. All right. So now I want to talk about. Your project. Explain to me about the Unchurched experience.
It's for street people, people that you know. You don't actually have to be street, but if you love God and you don't go to church, but you pray, you know, every night you pray, cover your family or whatever, and you don't go to church, that's the Unchurched experience. Say, for instance, if you don't know how to love and you want to learn how to love and, you know, you need something just for motivation and you don't have motivation at all, this EP is going to give you motivation.
Hey, sis. So you have anything else going on?
I'm doing that. I'm mentoring. I've been mentoring for a while. The name
you
of my mentoring program. It's really a mentoring program. I just do different things with them, you know, modeling, dancing, stuff like that. So that's KB Dolls. And I love working with those young girls. I just added on liturgical dance. So they're doing, you know. Now I'm doing prom giveaways. So I dress them. I get the dress. I dress them. And I collab with hairstylists, makeup artists, nail techs. And, you know, get their hair done, nails done, and their makeup done. I'm also traveling around. It's a tour, sis.
Gotcha.
So the Unchurched Experience tour, I mean, I'm still Key Black. I'm still, you know, doing bounce music and other music as well. And I'm just cleaning it up, you know, just inspiring people in the process of doing it and motivating people as well.
Well, thank you for your work in the community. Y'all make sure y'all check my girl out, get her project. And I want to thank you so much for coming here. We got a gift for you.
I like gifts.
Yes. Today's episode was sponsored by Anybody's Closet. So here it is. This is what she sent over. And this
thank
nice
you.
Little bag.
We got to see what I got.